What's up, YouTube? Gizmo here, TGP Gaming. Today a little bit different as normal. I just wanted to make a quick video about this topic. Because is YouTube actually going to die? They have done something, a new update. They didn't told us about it. And we just had to find out it today. At least I found it out today. And we're going to discuss it right now. But before we do, I just wanted to say that this video is... will be uploaded on a creative common license, so you may, and you are allowed to, I give you the permission to download this video and place it on your YouTube channel without editing or things like that. You can just pick it up and just place it on your YouTube channel, spread the word, because that is what we need to do right now if we want to stop YouTube from what it's doing. So let's go right into it and discuss this topic. So you're probably thinking, what is going on? What is he talking about? YouTube gonna die? What is happening? Well, let me explain you something. Normally when YouTube make an update, then it will give you a mail, or it will give you a new terms of agreement or anything like that. But it will give you, it will let you know what is happening so you are up to date, right? Right, something happened and they didn't update us. I just found it out today because Freedom on the George Show, thank you for that, buddy. He made a video on a new update that we suddenly just found out. George was getting himself an update from one of his viewers and he made a video on it. So I thought by myself, you know, we need to spread this message. We need to talk about it. So that's why I also say you can take this video, you can upload it on your channel. I do not mind at all. But the problem right now is YouTube has updated something, decreasing your views, probably also decrease the amount of subscribers that you get per month, meaning in the end also decreasing a lot of your income. And I have seen that for myself, and I didn't make that much on YouTube yet. I mean, we're just talking about a few dollars, but still, if you're putting a lot of effort into YouTube, making the content that you like to make, and then suddenly you just, everything just like goes, it just like takes a big dip, and you're just asking yourself, like, what the hell am I doing wrong? Why are my newest videos not getting that much views as it was used to be? Well, what happened is, normally when you subscribe to a YouTube channel, because that is what YouTube is, you know, you subscribe to a channel and you follow it, you want to get updates. That's why you subscribe, right? You don't subscribe to a channel that you don't want to have updates from. So you subscribe to a channel if you want to have updates from it, if you want to follow that channel, and things like that. Well, what is actually happening right now, and this is, guys, this is something YouTube did not told us. We just found it out today, at least I found it out today by that video of George. And what is, like, normally, I'll just let you see, you guys see it right away and then just go into it. I'll just open my browser quick and I'll let you see what is actually changed. So I'm in right here. Well, I make a little promotion for him right now because he's actually an awesome dude. I've been watching a few videos on it, but that to the side, I was not talking about that. We have here that big red subscribe button. Normally we just click on it, we subscribe. When he places a new video, I get an update. Everything cool, I watch that update, watch that video, and just, you know, that's how it goes. Not anymore. That just doesn't work anymore. You can now see when I subscribe on his channel, you will see here the bell icon popping up. So what happens actually if I click on the bell icon? You will see this. You will see that there is something new with the notifications of the people that you subscribe to. And this is very annoying because meaning that now every time when you subscribe on a channel, you will not automatically get updates on his videos because it will standing on highlights. You have to, after you subscribe, you have to click on the bell, click on all, and then say save if you want to have these updates. So many people just don't know about this, right? You normally would think you click that big red subscribe button, you're all done, you go on with the things you do, and you will get, well, your phone starts to ring or anything like that if you have that installed, when a new video pops up. Well, that is just not anymore. I will not get any updates other than some highlights from this channel due to this new update, because YouTube now in default will put it on highlights, not giving you any kind of update other than some highlights of this channel. So now you just like post some new videos on your channel and you just wonder just like, why I'm not getting any views? Simply because nobody sees it, nobody gets the update, nobody will see your video. Other than they actually specifically would go to your channel and watch what's new. Now you would probably say, maybe this is good, now I would not get spammed that much. Well, that is what YouTube actually says. We done this so you won't get spammed that much with all the videos from all your subscriptions and things like that. I'm just gonna put this quickly on before I forget it, because this is the problem. You wouldn't notice this, so you wouldn't get any updates, right? But for the person that creates the video, it's even worse, because he's just like not getting the subscriber of the view amount, what he normally would get on the video. That maybe also in turn, you know, will reflect on your subscriber amount, because if you don't get that much views, YouTube will simply not advertise you that much, and if YouTube doesn't advertise you that much, you just will lose a lot of traffic, and that is harmful for each and everyone's channel. Now, this could, I would not say this could be good or could be bad for bigger channels, because if I was like a guy like PewDiePie or Matthew Santoro or things like that, great people, big people on YouTube, I will probably every day type his name in, start searching for his channel and watch all the updates. But if you are a smaller channel like me, for example, I right now have 239 subscribers. I mean, thank you for that. I am very, very much appreciating 239 people following me, definitely indeed. But right now, those 239 people will not receive any updates when my videos get posted. At least that is from my understanding, from what I see right now happening on YouTube. And this is not what YouTube actually was before, because I click on that big red subscribe button mainly to get updated about the videos that that person posts on his YouTube channel. If I just want to, you know, look at his channel whenever I want to, I'll just not subscribe, go to the channel, and look if anything is there that I want to watch, right? But I want to have updates on his channel, and that's why I hit that big red subscribe button. That is the meaning of that subscribe button, but no longer, no anymore. It's just not the way it works right now. You have to subscribe, you have to click on this button, and you have to change it to all in order to get the updates that you want. And this can potentially be very, very bad, dangerous, or however you want to call it, for your YouTube channel, especially if you're smaller or mid-range or anything like that, because you just lose a lot of views. And again, if you lose too much views on your videos, you lose advertisements, and that is the most important thing on YouTube. It's traffic, 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 traffic. It's all about traffic. It's all about trying to reach as a big amount of audience as you're trying to get by, you know, getting more subscribers, getting more views, getting more advertisements. But also, if you do not get that much of views, companies like Samsung, Nokia, Nokia is still existing, but anyhow, they will not be interested in putting advertisements on your videos, mainly because you don't have that much of views. So your our CPM rate, or however they want to call it, the amount that, you know, advertisers would pay for putting advertisements on your video, will become substantially lower just because of the fact that you don't have that much of views. And when I talk about advertisement, I'm not just talking about the advertisements I will get on my video in order to make money, because just to be honest, it's not just about the money, it's about having fun, it's about doing what you like to do. And if you want to become a big YouTuber, and I see that there's a lot on YouTube that big YouTubers go like, oh, I'm not doing this for the money, what I just call big bullshit. Because if those guys would not earn the amount of money that they would earn, they would simply not be doing YouTube, because they would have a job, because they would have to pay for their homes, for their equipment, and for everything that they need to do to be on YouTube. So I just call it big bullshit when they say, you know, we're not doing it for the money, because that is just not true. That's just a big fat lie, and that's just always been a big fat lie, because simply just what I said just a moment ago, if you want to become a big YouTuber, if you want to become, if you want to do this as a living, you need to pay for your home, you need to pay for everything you do in order to stay that much on YouTube. But that is also not what I'm talking about. It's just what I wanted to drop quickly. The viewer amount is actually what I want to talk about, because the more views you're gonna get on your video, the more YouTube will advertise you. And when I'm talking about advertising, so if we go just quickly back to my browser here, and we're going to, for example, just go to the home channel. We're just going to the home channel, and of course we see here a lot of advertisements for a lot of videos for a lot of people. And you will only get on this channel if your video, on this homepage, if your video gets watched a lot. So meaning, the more your video gets watched, you will be on this channel. You will have recommend to watch, of course, because are things that you like to watch. For example, me, I like to watch Top Gear. This is my own channel. So you will, I will see this here because I have watched it with my channel. When I go to bed, I like to have some meditation music on. I like to meditate and things like that. So I will see my channel here also. But the main reason, like if I would go just like click on a video, just like click on a video. Let's go here to the George Show for a moment, and I'm gonna click on this video. You will see here up next. This is also one of the advertisements that YouTube does. The more views you get, the more often you will be here on the up next to watch. This is also an advertisement, and YouTube will do this so many times depending on how much views you get, depending on how much subscriptions you have. The more people want to see your channel, the more YouTube will advertise you, and that is just mainly what YouTube is. It is about reaching a bigger audience, getting more views, getting more subscriptions, grow bigger, be in a big community, interact with people and things like that. But how does YouTube wants me to interact with people if I cannot reach those people? Explain me that. I want to reach my audience. I want to reach my people that follow me, but I cannot reach them because they simply do not see the updates on my video. And that can be potentially very, very harmful for my channel. I, for just to keep it on me for a moment, I saw a big drop in my views. And mainly just because of this. And I think just like why, just like we put so much effort in making these videos, we put so much effort and so much hours in making some great and good content, trying to be as professional as possible, and hoping of course that YouTube tries to advertise, at least advertise me as many as possible, giving me a bigger audience, giving me more traffic. But right now it's just compromising that, because my view amount is getting lower because you know, people don't see the updates that they should see, and people just don't get to my video. That is the problem what we're facing right now. And what I don't understand is, that is really what I don't understand. First of all, why is YouTube not telling us that they have made this, actually, for what I have to say, a pretty much important update? Why did YouTube not tell us about it? Why didn't they inform us about it so we are prepared and we can actually say something about it? I'm not sure, but I have some theories, so I will be coming to that in just a moment. But what I want to quickly say before that is, if I subscribe to a YouTube channel, I subscribe to a YouTube channel just mainly because I want to get updates of that channel. Why is YouTube not simply giving me the opportunity to choose myself? For example, if I would go click here on the subscribe button, I see this bell here. Why is it not just as normally standing on default, for example, on all, and then giving me the opportunity to choose if I want to turn this off, but leaving the default on all as it always have been? Why is YouTube suddenly making the choice for me to not get the updates and just the highlights? And I'm not really sure what they mean about highlights. Is it just like that you get a highlight like once every month? I mean, I get a mail in my mail every month, like, hey, these people in your subscriptions have posted these videos, so you have to check them out. You should check them out. That is the mail that I get once a month, and everybody probably is getting them if you have subscribed for that mail. But right now, YouTube forces me to change the setting for each and every channel that I subscribe to and I'm going to subscribe to. I'm not really understanding why YouTube does this. So, as I said, I have a theory, a few actually. Well, I don't know if there are theories or things like that, but just hear me out for a second. There are a lot of small channels. Me, I am also a small channel. I try to make my content as professional as possible, try to make my first few seconds in the video very catchy, then make a good intro, and just bring the video as most professional as I can onto YouTube, because that is what you guys want. You guys want to see a professional looking video. People don't care if the YouTube channel is big or small, as long as the content is good on the channel, people will follow your channel. And that is how channels get big. People just like stumble upon your channel, look some videos, see like, that looks great, that looks great, that looks professional, that is something that I really like to follow. I click that subscribe button and I will just see what's gonna happen, what kind of videos he's gonna post, and I will just decide if I will keep just like following them, or him, or she, or whatever. I mean, why is YouTube changing this? Why is YouTube making such an important update, not telling us about it? Well, I was thinking just a moment ago, and as I said, there are a lot of small channels, and a lot of channels, and no offense to you guys all, but there are a lot of channels, and then I see those videos, and I'm really like, dude, you just have, just like, you made a really awesome banner, you have a really awesome picture, you have all your social media links and everything like that, but then the videos, like, no intros. Some people choose to have no intros, but, like, there is just, like, bad quality, bad sound quality, and just like mainly you see that video and you already have the feeling that you want to click away to another video in like 10 seconds or something like that. That's bad, it's not good. And if that happens, meaning that those people will not really earn something. Now, this is the funny part. YouTube takes 45% of what you earn. So every dollar that you earn, you're getting around 55 cents and YouTube takes the rest. Now, I was just recording yesterday and I was looking at the file size that I was creating, and I saw that just a video of half an hour was having a file size of 40 gigs. Now, what I could do is I could compress that file into maybe a gig or maybe 2 gig, maybe a few hundred MB, but that takes, for some applications, over an hour to do that. After that, I have to upload it. Well, if it's still an hour video or half an hour video, it will still take you around 30 minutes to an hour. It's like equivalent to how long your video is to upload and process that video. But here comes the bigger part. If you do not earn that much on YouTube because you don't have that much of views, then basically, and I'm sorry to say it, you're basically dead weight for YouTube. Because YouTube has to pay a lot of money to keep those servers running where we can upload to. And as we know, every day on YouTube, the amount of videos, the duration of videos that get uploaded is like a year long watching. So every day there's like a year of videos in length that gets uploaded to YouTube. Now, if you would actually turn that around into how much geek that would be, we would not even be talking about geeks anymore. I just say I created a 30 minute video and it's like 40 geeks, and let's say it's like, this is just half an hour. Well, how many minutes are there in a year? Well, a lot more than just half an hour. So this is what is happening. YouTube needs to have a lot of these servers to keep all these videos uploaded, to keep everything fast, to keep everything from lagging out, and to have enough room for everybody to place their videos on. So daily, YouTube is buying new servers, is opening new offices, and things like that, to put on new servers, and it just goes on like that. So if you do not make any kind of money, YouTube doesn't make money from you, but YouTube still has to provide the space for you to upload the video. And then I would say, in YouTube's perspective, that would be dead weight. YouTube is not earning on it, YouTube is losing money on it. So I think this could be a way for YouTube to minimize the smaller accounts, right? That is what I would say. YouTube would just forcibly make smaller channels even make less, like let you have the feeling that you're not getting anywhere, giving up, and so YouTube can just like free space on the service for people that actually make good content where they actually make some money off. That is what I think is actually happening here. So we can have a whole topic, a whole discussion about YouTube, you know, canceling out the little channels because it's costing them a lot of money. But at the other hand, YouTube is the most viewed and most visited site of just like the whole planet, you could say. What is a pretty big status. First it was Facebook, but now it's YouTube. And with the millions of money that YouTube makes daily on creators, on advertisements and things like that, I would seriously question myself, question YouTube, if they would actually lose money from the smaller channels. There is so much money that they gain from the bigger channels, I'm not really sure if they would actually lose money from the smaller channels. But that's something that we can brainstorm about, we just don't know. This is what we can talk about for hours, for days, for months, we just don't know. Another thing could be copyright infringements. There are a lot of channels that do copyright infringements. Yeah, that there are just so many channels that do that. If I want to watch a video on, for example, just take one, Top Gear, a very famous one, gets, Clarkson was still hosting the show, it got around 350 million views worldwide every time when the show was online, no? So that's a lot of views. And what people try to do is, they try to place the same footage that was on the television on YouTube, but what they do is they make a background and they just give it like a little small view of that video, mainly to bypass the copyright engine, right? And I hate those channels. Really, I do not like those channels. Mainly because they try all kind of neat and tricky things to bypass that copyright, which should not be done. There's nothing in terms of agreement that we should respect, but we also agreed with it when we started this channel. So what could it be? Copyright infringements? Could it be that YouTube tries this way to cancel out those channels? I don't know. Those channels get a lot of views because people want to see those shows. So I'm not really sure if this is the perfect way to do that. But for the rest, why? Why is YouTube forcing me to not get updates on these channels for what normally would happen? And why is YouTube putting it on highlights? Why is YouTube making these updates? And this is not the first time that YouTube changes something in their terms of agreement that would actually hurt a lot of YouTubers. For example, I'm a gamer and I game a lot and I do a lot of fast-paced games, and then something goes wrong and I call the F word. I mean, that happens a lot. Right now, a lot of YouTubers, their videos get unmonetized because of that, because they say words like that, because they use things like that in their title, in their thumbnails and things like that. They get like demonetized. And as I saw today, somebody was calling you guilty until proven otherwise. And that is exactly what they do. And that is, well, I have to say, at one point it's good, because people make, for example, they have a video about cars and then they say somebody killed me or something like that. The title is just completely misleading from the video that they actually created. They put things in their thumbnails of in their text that has nothing to do with their video, just to try to get more views, just to try to get higher in the search engine. And yes, what I like to say is YouTube is even harder than finding a job. I would quicker find a job than become big on YouTube. YouTube is not easy to do and it's not for everyone. But that said, I think YouTube does need to give everybody its fair try. And right now, for what I see, is that the big YouTube channels get a lot from YouTube. YouTube even pays their flights to and their hotels and things like that if they want to go to those big parties and things like that. That mean and smaller YouTubers don't get anything. The whole system that YouTube is using is already unfair. I mean, small YouTubers get no help whatsoever, If you make a support ticket and things like that, you can wait for months if you even get something back. If a big YouTuber makes a support ticket, they can have an answer in an hour. I mean, YouTube is already making it difficult for smaller YouTubers, and now they're making it even more difficult. Every time when YouTube make an update like this, smaller YouTubers get just a kick under the nuts. That is just how it feels for me. This is just like a kick under my nuts. I'm trying to do my very best to make something nice for you guys. What I like to do, and as I said, I appreciate all my followers, and I really, really thank you guys for following me. I really, really appreciate it. I can't express how much I appreciate it. But I do not really appreciate what YouTube is doing right now. But we can go on for this for hours, and I could talk about this for hours, and I don't think you guys want to listen to the same thing over and over and over again as I'm talking right now. But this is just what I want to address quickly, and this is just something that I think it's unfair for YouTube to do for the smaller channels. YouTube, if you change something, then at least let us know. And if you change something, for example like this, the notifications, let the setting be on what it was, and then when we subscribe on that big red button, just give us this like little pop-up window asking us, do we want to have none, do we want to have highlights, or do we want to have all the updates from that channel? Do we want that? That is what the question should be. Do we want that? It's not what YouTube wants. Do we want that? We are the people that made YouTube big. We are the people that is generating the income for YouTube. That we are doing that. YouTube is not doing that. We are doing that. YouTube is taking 45% from everybody's channel. Everybody is doing a lot of work, spend a lot of hours to make this great, awesome content. YouTube just takes 45% of it. I'm not saying that is bad, because that's very good. That's why YouTube can get new servers, that's why we always have space to upload, and that's why we are free to go on YouTube as ever we want to go. But YouTube is just like limiting what we can do on YouTube every month. It's just not fair. All the bigger YouTubers get all whatever what they want. They get, for example, they already get more and better advertisements because, just to be honest, it's just more interesting for a company like Samsung to make an advertisement on a YouTuber with a few million subscribers than a YouTuber like me with 239 subscribers. And I do not blame them for that. It's just more beneficial for them for the money that they pay. I can get that. No problem. We all have to work for our future. We all have to work for our success. That's always how it's been. But why does YouTube need to make it so difficult for us? I don't know. This is just something I want to address. And this is something I think we need to talk about. Because if we don't, YouTube just makes these changes for us. And it just makes it more and more difficult for us. And this is just not helping us to grow bigger. One quick thing I want to say is we saw a lot of YouTubers, big YouTubers, fail. Because things they say, because they cannot just keep on generating enough content that has enough diversity. And people just lose interest in their channels, unsubscribe and things like that. It can happen to me, it can happen to PewDiePie, it can happen to any other channel. And we have seen that in the past. So if bigger YouTubers fail, some new person needs to step in and become the new something, you know? That right here, that competition gets right caught in the middle, because a lot of YouTubers just right now would stop YouTube for doing what they like to do just because they have the feeling they fail because nobody watched their videos. Simply because people don't get the updates. So I'm not really sure what YouTube is trying to do. And if that actually, if YouTube keeps doing things like this, would this actually be the end of YouTube? I mean, we have seen Facebook fail. Facebook had this new policy that if you place pictures on Facebook is allowed to use those pictures in advertisements. So just to say it really, really weird for a moment, just to go really, really big on it, is like, don't be looking weird if you drive along the road and suddenly you see one of your pictures on a billboard, you know? Because that is actually standing in the terms of agreement. That is what YouTube is, Facebook is allowed to. Not even that. They are reading your SMS. They are reading everything what you do on your phone. They are activating your camera to record what you do. They are activating your microphone to record what you do. Main focus is to advertise. To advertise directly onto you. And to advertise for what you want to see. For things you want to buy. How can they understand what you want is by just spying on you and then knowing what you want. And there's not, like, I don't know if you guys know what WhatsApp is, at least that it's an app that we use to text right here in the Netherlands, but it became encrypted, and it has a reason it became encrypted, to guarantee our privacy. So, but I just don't want to go on that topic, because that is something completely different, maybe for another video. But this is just what I wanted to say. YouTube, if you make a change like this, leave it as it was. Just give us like an update notification, like as you would see this window, and let us choose what we want to do. But at least keep YouTube as it was. Keep YouTube as it became big. We made YouTube big, and now I have a feeling that we just get backstabbed. That is just basically what is happening right now. So you can agree with what I say, you may be not agreeing with what I say. I would really appreciate if you leave a comment in the comment section below. Let me know what you think about this new update on YouTube. Do you like it or do you not like it? Let me know, because this is really important that we talk about this. Now, quickly, by the way, it's like, yeah, you see these updates, these numbers on, you know, how much videos people have been posted. You still see them. So you can say, basically, we still see those updates. Now, I do not have that much of subscriptions that I subscribe to. I mean, it's not a long list or something like that. But people have lists like that are 10 times bigger than my list is. It's just, you won't be following all of that. You just won't. And what I see also a lot of times is people place like 10 videos and they only have 3 updates. It's just like they're seeing number 3, but there are a lot of more videos updated on that channel. So it's not fail proof. It just isn't. So I just want to keep it at here. I just wanted to say this. I would say just take this video, put it on your YouTube channel, share this, because I made this video on a Creative Commons license. You can use this video, share the word, share the message, make your own video, place it on your YouTube, let people know what is happening. Not mainly just to say what you want to say and say what you want to think about this specific topic, but just also to let people know, if they subscribe to a channel, they have to undergo a few extra steps if they want to be updated and to get notifications on that channel. But as I said, I just wanted to quickly address this. I hope you appreciate the information. I hope that it will fix some problems for you. I hope it will answer some questions for you. If you want me to make some more of these videos addressing some more topics, all kind of things, let me also know in the comment section below. I'll see if I can make some extra videos on things like this. Just talk a little around, talk about some general subjects that you guys want to be talking about. Let me know in the comment section below and I will look at that for later. I would say to you, thanks for watching this video. I appreciate it a lot that you watch this video, because we have to spread this message. I can't say it enough. We have to spread this message. So please do. I would say thank you for watching my video. I hope to see you on one of my other videos. I would say stay cool. Let's keep it rolling. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Ooh, no, not again. Not again. Get over. Get over. Uh-oh. 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 No! No! Forest! Key!